They are doubling tomorrow, so you'll be following where the ferries are going. It takes the ferry just over 3 hours, about 3 1/4 hours, to get from Holyhead to Dublin. And they do that twice a day. And there's another one, Irish Ferries, which is a green and white shamrock sorry, just waving at the other guy, two of my friends here. There we go. And so lots of tours going out from your ship today, about 19 of them, I think. So a lot of tours, very busy. But as you can see, we're in a very, very busy working day. The cruise ship is docked today. You can see all of the containers here on our left. Again, we have a lot of ferry traffic, or container traffic on the ferries, that comes from all over the world, via Southern Ireland, from Dublin over to here, the UK, which is no longer part of Europe. As you may have heard, a few years ago we left the EU, so we're now not a European country anymore. Although when it comes, that's politically, when it comes to other things, we are very much still in a camaraderie situation with the other countries of Europe. I don't think that will ever change, particularly because we're all part of NATO as well. And that becomes important when we have things going on like the Ukraine and Russia at the moment. Ukraine is applying to be part of NATO. It wants to have NATO countries looking after it because of what's going on with Russia at the moment. But we won't get too heavily into politics at all. I can tell you anything you'd like to know about Welsh and UK politics. Any questions that you have during the day that you'd like me to cover, that you have a special interest in perhaps. I will be covering quite a wide number of subjects as we go through the tour today. But let's just tell you a little bit about where we are. Once we leave this port, we're all part at the moment you can see the town of Holyhead over on your right hand side there, and you'll see a little square tower of a church coming up on your right hand side. So if you want to, as we're going to the mountain, there it is, that is the tower of the church of St. Kevi. And St. Kevi is the Welsh name of Holyhead. So Holyhead is known in Welsh as Caia Gybi. Caia Gybi. Caia, C-A-E. Fortress. A fortress. I'll tell you here later on this afternoon.
That's a funny brain.
And so Caia Gybi, Kybi, changes
those
to G to be Caia Gybi. It's a Welsh thing.
It has to be told, of course.
We have changed the letters in Welsh, but we do. And so Caia Gybi is the Welsh name for Holyhead. And it's named after St. Kevi. He was one of these guys 1,400 years ago. 1,400 years ago, we were settled to set up little religious cells, if you like, all over Wales, all over the UK as well. Out of the port now, we're coming to the exit of the port. And up on the left-hand side there, on the hill, then you'll see a little obelisk up there. That is to Captain John McGregor Skinner. Captain John McGregor Skinner. He was actually born in the USA, in the state of New Jersey. And he fought for the British during the time of the independence, the War of Independence. When you decided he lost an arm, he came back here to Holyhead to work on what we call the packet ships. P-A-C-K-E-T, packet, which means the postal ships. They look after the post that is going between here and Ireland. And was a captain on the packet ships going forth from Holyhead to Dublin, as you'll be doing later on today. Here in Holyhead, coming from across the Atlantic, across Ireland. He was washed overboard and drowned. But he was a great philanthropist. He put a lot of money into the town, that monument to him. And ships that were coming into Holyhead before we had GPS and all those kind of things, they would use that monument as a guide coming into the port of Holyhead.
I
Just a note here that if it gets too warm for you, or you like the air conditioning on, hopefully it will warm up a little bit later on. Then please do shout down to Kai and he can put that on for you. Everything's automatic here. Temp. Also adjust things above your head as well if you don't want the air coming down onto you. Please feel free to shout down if it gets too warm. You can see most things from both sides of the coach. However, you'll get a good view of the suspension bridge as we go from Anglesey that we're coming up to now. Only best view of the mountains, although after lunch you're both on both sides. That's the first bridge ever to be built, the biggest suspension bridge in the world when it was built in 1826. And so if you're interested in bridges, I suggest you're on the left hand side of the coach. Coming back, you don't get such a great view. This is set up first of all, it began with the only part of Europe that had not capitulated to the Nazi army. And so you were very kindly sending over. Of course, the jet was sunk to the bottom of the Mediterranean Sea. And so the UK had to guard it to stop the Russians and the Chinese from getting to all the stealth technology. Today is going to be a roast chicken breast with sage and onion stuffing. There will be potatoes, broccoli and carrots with some gravy, and then the dessert will be strawberries and cream. So that's roast chicken breast with sage and onion stuffing, and roast and potatoes, boiled potatoes, not roast potatoes. Broccoli and carrots with gravy, and then dessert will be strawberries and cream. There'll be water on the tables, and you'll also have the choice. The staff, when we get there, will take your orders for either a glass of beer, or a glass of house or white red wine, or a soft drink, and it's up to you if you'd like to order one of those. So either a glass of beer, a glass of wine, red or white house wine, or a soft drink. You'll have water on the table, and then after your lunch, if you want to have tea or coffee, you can also order those. It's all included in your lunch today. So if you have any problems with any of that, I need to know immediately we get to the station, please, because I know the hotel will not be aware.
This is at the station.
If you've had our lunch, you'll have a little bit of free time to explore Beth Sequoyd, where we're having our lunch. And then after that, we'll be going for a drive into the mountains, the mountains of Snowdonia National Park. And then we'll finish our tour this afternoon before we come back to the ship with a stop at medieval Carnarvon Castle. The reason, it probably says on your itinerary, it mentions, I'm not sure if it did mention Conwy, but Conwy has a lot of building work. They're repairing the bridge at Conwy, and so we can't go that way, which is why we're rerouting to Carnarvon, which is much larger, and it's smack bang in front of the coach when we park there in Carnarvon. So that will be a photo stop with the final restrooms of the tour before we come back to your ship. So that is your itinerary for today on the tour. You'll start to see the mountains of Snowdonia in the distance, in the mist, on your right and your left now. And that's where we're heading for as we head down to our train. New York Railway. Now, as we come to Carnarvon, where we're going this afternoon, the reason it's dangerous is because it's very narrow and it's tidal. So that means that the tide comes in very forcibly, twice a day, into that narrow stretch of water. So it creates some very dangerous currents. And there's already hidden sand So the only way to for a human to get over here, he built a world UNESCO World Heritage Site aqueduct. He built roads that we'll be travelling on later after lunch. He built an important road that we're going to see right now coming up. Now we're going over the more modern built as a railway bridge in 1850, so not that much longer. But as the railways came into Wales in 1850, then we had a bridge being built, a railway bridge being built. The original bridge, as the Venture Bridge, was for coach and horses. Going over on is the originally a railway bridge called the Britannia Bridge. The Britannia Bridge. After a big fire, if you look in the distance, there's a gap in the trees. You'll see a big house there. That is the house of the first. On your left now, you will get a view of the Menai Bridge. And there's also a little white cottage down there as well. Now that cottage has a wall around there. The tide is not fully in at the moment. It's just on its way out. That bridge, that wall around that little cottage there, is a fishing trap. So when the fish are brought in on the tide, because it's a circular wall, they can't then escape. So it's a way of catching fish without using traps or hooks or nets of any kind. It's a natural fishing trap. And families used to live in that little white cottage for many, many years, right up until by the last owners and soldiers of Holyhead. They used to bring up their families there. Used to sell their catch either on the island of Anglesey or on mainland Wales, where we are now.
Vegetables.
carve a wall of Porthmadog. It was built by William Meadows, and he built the harbour of Porthmadog, and it's named after him. Porth, P-O-R-T-H, means port train, gravity train. Because before the steam was invented, and that was yet to come in about 40, 50 years, before steam was developed, they had to rely on gravity. Now, just to explain to you what slate is, if you've never come across slate before, it made a lot of people here in North Wales extremely rich, and they were the people that owned the mines and the factories. They tended to be English as opposed to Welsh people who had settled here in North Wales. We will be looking at some of the huge remains of what was left. But we became known during the Industrial Revolution that made us very, very rich here as the slate that roofed the world. The slate that roofed the world. Have a look at these houses here on your left and the roofs on the houses. They have slate roofs. And that's why we were known as the slate that roofed the world. 500 million years ago, when we were down in the Mediterranean, and then tectonic plates moved us further up north to where we are today, then 500 million years ago, the mountains of Snowdonia were formed. And during that time, the mud that was at the bottom of the Mediterranean, talk to you about that a bit later. If we look at 500 million years ago, then to get slate you need a lot of heat and pressure to change the mud that is now in the mountains to slate rock. That date for you there, it was the 15th of September 1939 that it was closed to passengers. 15th of September 1939. There was no slate revival, and it's the 1st of August 1946, just after World War II, the 1st of August when it closed completely for slate and other rocks as well. But not long after that, 1951, then volunteers got together and started the railway as a heritage railway. So today you will be travelling on 13.5 miles of railway on the Ffestiniog. But they also now work together with the Welsh Highland Railway. So you can go on both from Porthmadog. You can take the Ffestiniog Railway from Blaenau to Porthmadog, and then you can connect up with the Welsh Highland Railway, which is 2 hours that goes through Snowdonia National Park up to Carnarvon, where we're going on lunch this afternoon. And just remember that when you're on the train today, when you're at the station, almost all of the staff, apart from those in the ticket office and head office doing the marketing, are volunteers. They're working at the Ffestiniog or the Welsh Highland because they love steam heritage railways. So just please remember that today. The majority of the people you'll see on the railway are volunteers. They're not paid to do what they do. They do it because they love it.
Tables, you will see maps anyway of where you're going. So it
has a map of the Ffestiniog and the Welsh Highland Railway on the double tables, so that you can check out where you are when you see the sign. The main stops we will be doing are Minford, Tanaport, and after that we go to Viath, and we go to Tanagrashai, and finally Glen Ffestiniog. As we start out, we will be going across the Carb, across the harbour that will be Maddoxville, and you get a lovely view together from the railway. And then we head off into the forest. You cannot get off at any of the stations, please remember that you have to stay on the train for the whole journey. And then just before we get to the end, next but one stop, the train will slow down dramatically. You'll start on your right-hand side to see a big lake, which is a hydroelectric plant. And then on your left-hand side, as you're coming into Tanagrashai, you will get to not see the glass, should you choose to do that. So look out for that, last but one stop, Tanagrashai.